Over the past 40 years, the Houston Police Department's crime lab has evolved from a one-man operation to a high-tech facility operated by a staff of over 70 well-trained forensic scientists.
The crime lab was established in 1953. Since then, there's been tremendous advances, as you can imagine, from the 1950s until now, 2010. For example, a lot of the work done was using microscopes, rudimentary tests, but they were state-of-the-art at that time. Nowadays, the computers, with the advancements in computers, were able to automate processes for drug testing. DNA is now in place. Well, in the 1950s, it was not available. Nowadays, we have DNA testing, and literally, the possibilities are in the millions, where we can identify a person with greater certainty and say that is the person that left that blood sample at a scene. Another advance that we have are the databases, DNA databases, where we can identify a perpetrator that left a sample at a scene, either DNA, fingerprints. Those are a couple of the types of databases that are available.
Forensic science and modern technology has played a crucial role in assisting law enforcement agencies across the country in analyzing data, identifying suspects, and helping to solve crimes. The mission of HPD's Crime Lab is to seek the truth and evidence, says Irma Rios, Crime Lab Director for the Houston Police Department.
So in other words, when we analyze the evidence, we can testify as to what the results are. We don't change them in any way. The evidence and the results are what they are.
Through the years, the Houston Police Department has made great strides to maintain a level of integrity and high standards for its nationally recognized crime laboratory. It has been recognized by the Bureau of Alcohol, Tobacco, Firearms, and Explosives and the International Association of Chiefs of Police. HPD's Crime Lab has also met specific standards for accreditation. In 2005, all sections were accredited except for DNA, which was accredited in 2006.
Accreditation is not required in every state for all different disciplines. It is for DNA. Every DNA lab that participates in the CODIS entry or in the database, they're required to be accredited. But the other forensic areas, for example, controlled substances, firearms, are not required.
Like many crime labs across the country, the Houston Police Department has had its share of challenges to overcome through the years. One of the largest problems the lab had to confront occurred from 2002 through 2006, when HPD had to discontinue DNA testing in the lab after an outside audit found widespread deficiencies within the DNA serology section.
A comprehensive review was conducted of the whole lab, not just the DNA section, and there were major issues. Over 3,000 cases were reviewed for the entire lab. We have had panels review where there's a question where an individual might have been wrongfully incarcerated or convicted. But we are on the tail end of that. We should be done with that in 2 months, and that will be a chapter that will be closed in the lab. That we've looked at everything, left no stone unturned, and made sure nobody is incarcerated that shouldn't be.
As a result of the audit, there was a major overhaul of the crime laboratory. Additional staff and new technology has enabled the laboratory to operate more efficiently and effectively.
We're able to link weapons to crime scenes or to evidence at scenes that they had no idea. So we're doing a lot more intelligence work type. We are also putting in robotics where there's less manual handling by an examiner and robots are put in place. We have laboratory information management systems where we can link evidence to cases and be able to do this very quickly as opposed to the paper manual. It takes a lot of time.
According to Director Rios, crime labs across the country are faced with limited resources to handle a backlog of cases.
Why do we have backlogs in crime labs? It has to do with technology changing. It used to take the size of a dime to the size of a quarter to get a result for a DNA profile. Now it takes the size of a pinhead. So we can do a lot more with a lot less. Technology is constantly changing. We're having to train staff, implement the technology into the crime lab. And that takes time. We have to remove analysts from conducting casework so they can train. So we're juggling a lot of things at the same time. and the caseload continues to come in.
We are very grateful that City Council approved the 4 contracts for DNA testing. This allows us to handle the backlog while we're also implementing new technology and, for example, automation robots.
HPD's crime lab typically processes about 30,000 requests on an annual basis, with about 2,000 of those cases for DNA testing. While DNA testing from the biology section of the lab currently has the biggest demands, there are also other sections of the lab that handle a large caseload as well.
The crime lab is composed of many units. It includes the controlled substances section, the toxicology and breath test, trace evidence testing, DNA, biology, firearms, our quality assurance program, our laboratory information management system. So it's a very complex system in, as far as the lab is concerned.
Next, you'll learn more about some of the daily functions of the various sections of HPD's crime lab.
Biology department is concerned with finding pieces of evidence, finding fluids, biological fluids on pieces of evidence. We do so by a series of different tests, but my specific portion looks for blood and semen via a series of chemical and observation techniques. And we use a series of chemical tests to determine if something has been deposited onto the evidence in question. We have things like phenolphthalein, acid phosphatase that we test for blood and semen. We also have alternate light sources, which are 2 machines that we have in the lab that we can view articles of clothing or other pieces of evidence to see if something has been deposited on them as well.
The majority of casework we process is sexual assault related. So much of the evidence would be from sexual assault kits, such as vaginal swabs, anal swabs, that sort of sample. But we get blood swabs from crime scenes. We get items that have that touch DNA on it, where someone handled an instrument, and we can try to swab that item and collect the DNA from that whatever it is we're testing, and try to get a DNA profile that way. You'll see some older technology like microscopy. That's not going to go away. Being able to look and view at things, very small things, is important. But a lot of newer equipment as well. We use what we call genetic analyzers, and these are computer-based systems that allow the DNA basically to be read.
I work in the toxicology section of the Houston Police Department Crime Laboratory, and there we analyze bodily fluids and breaths for the presence of alcohol and drugs. And what they do is ask, when they conduct a breath test, they just basically ask the subject to provide a sample, and at that point the instrument will basically take it from there and determine how much is required for that particular breath test.
Criminalists from the toxicology department also work with officers that operate the new breath alcohol testing vans.
Our primary responsibility with the breath alcohol testing vans is to ensure that the instruments within the breath alcohol testing vans are inspected and maintained. We do monthly inspections on them, and if there's any maintenance required, we also perform those as well.
What I'm most often asked to do is to examine hairs that were evidence from a crime scene or from an item of clothing recovered from a crime scene, and then compare them to some known hairs from one person or several persons who are involved with that case, whether they be suspects or complainants. I also can mount hairs and put them on slides and look at them with a comparison microscope, which is basically two microscopes that are linked together, and I can look through one viewfinder and see an image of whatever I have on one microscope next to the image of whatever I have on the other microscope. And for hairs, I can scroll through each hair from root to tip and have a side-by-side image of what I'm seeing to try to be able to see whether or not those internal characteristics are consistent throughout both hairs.
And in the firearms section, we analyze evidence that can include fired cartridge cases, bullets, shot shells, and the like, other fired components. And we also examine firearms to determine their functionality. Once I've done that, then I'll take it in and I'll test fire it. And I test fire it into a water tank primarily, and from there I can recover the fired bullets. And once I've done that, I'll take the unknowns, which is the evidence that came in, or the evidence from another case per se, and I'll look at that evidence compared to my known samples. And by looking at them, I can determine whether or not they were fired from the same firearm. We do this through the use of a comparison microscope.
Over the past 12 to 13 years, HPD's Crime Lab has operated one of the largest ballistic imaging programs in the world, says Daryl Stein, manager of HPD's firearms section.
What the program has evolved into now is a program run by the ATF. And this program allows us to enter firearms and firearms-related evidence into a database to search these items to see if a particular firearm was used in the commission of more than one crime.
Any pill, any tablet, any liquid, or any substance that's in conjunction with a case or they feel is, you know, maybe a possible controlled substance, they send it to our division. We have a plethora of instruments that we use. Primarily we use two confirmatory instruments, which is FTIR, Fourier Transform Infrared. It's an instrument that's used to specifically identify the unknown compound. GCMS is very, very specific and sensitive to unknown compounds to the naked eye. And we also use preliminary tests such as color tests, which is also screening tests, your serial agents on the desk, on our bench area, and we have them grouped together for different tests.
The crime lab staff is required to have a background and degree in science. Some of their duties include performing routine analysis of controlled substances and other evidence, interpreting analytical data, maintaining reports, and testifying in court regarding analysis.
I've been in forensics for about 25 years, and there has been a tremendous improvement. Before, it was shadowing somebody. Now it's very formal, with competency testing, a lot of checks and balances, proficiency on the back end. Once they're processing cases, do they maintain their competency? So the training is much more advanced nowadays. The types of positions that we have in the lab, by far the largest number of staff that we have, are criminalists. And criminalists are scientists. They have degrees in chemistry, biology, physical science. Criminalists in biology section, which conducts DNA testing, not only do they have to have a science degree, they must have three types of courses that are mandated by the FBI, and that includes genetics, biochemistry, and molecular biology. Firearms, it's physical science. So as you can see, the criminalists require scientific backgrounds, but we also look at other things, their integrity, their background. We obviously do not want somebody with a criminal history working in the crime lab.
The popularity of television shows like CSI has given fans some degree of knowledge about forensic science. However, according to director Rios, there is very little that is realistic on the television shows compared to what really happens in a crime lab.
Our criminalists or chemists do not go to a scene and collect the evidence. We have a crime scene unit that does that for the Houston Police Department. We're not classified or commissioned people. We're not police officers. We're scientists. We process the evidence and report the analysis, testify in court. So it's not the same. It's not as glamorous as what you see on TV.
As you can see, there have been significant improvements made within HPD's crime lab, such as a comprehensive quality assurance program, new and additional staffing, an accredited lab, as well as new technology. If you would like to learn more about careers in HPD's crime lab, go to www.houstontex.gov and click on I Want To, and then apply for a job.
Ready to fire.